Start.
Good afternoon, one and all present here. I am Sendil, research scholar, Anna University, under the research guidance of Dr. V. Jayanti, ma'am, professor of ECE department, PSNA College of Engineering and Technology, Dindukal. I am going to present the research title of design and implementation of subnormal floating point system on chip for secured signal processing using pipelined interconnection. Today, content deliveries are area of research, objective, introduction, existing work, problem identified, research direction, finally conclusion, and so some future enhancement in our proposed work. The area of research is VLSI data path design for floating point arithmetic. Objective, to enhance the subnormal processing capability in floating point arithmetic and to design efficient hardware for subnormal processing. During the subnormal processing, delay, area, power consumption are to be reduced. And then finally, timing related issue for subnormal processing are reduced in terms of data timing channel. Floating point arithmetic is a scientific notation for integer representation. It widely accepted for its accuracy and dynamic range. IEEE 754 floating point standard has four floating point format called half precision, single precision, double precision, and quartile precision. All precision has three field. One is sine field, second is exponent field, and third one is matrix of field. Its application area are signal processing, convolutional neural network, and cryptographic applications. And it efficiently handled the underflow, overflow exception efficiently. In exception, there are three exceptions are handled in floating point standard or IEEE standard. The subnormal, infinity, not a number. Subnormal is a underflow exception. Infinity is a overflow. Sometimes it's called as an invalid result. Not a number is a special case. Then go to its exponent range for single, double, and quartile precision. Its purpose of exponent, bias is to separate the largest and smallest normalized number. This range of normalized and subnormal numbers given in last table for single, double, and quad precision. In this slide shows how decimal number is converted into floating point number with various accuracy. Accuracy is nothing but a number of bits in fractional part. In here, IEEE 754 standard, fractional part are represented as a mantissa part. For example, 10.75 is represented as half precision in 10-bit accuracy. And in single 32-bit format, it has a 23-bit accuracy. In double precision, it has a 52-bit mantissa field. And then finally, quad precision has 112-bit for accuracy. In next, subnormal is represented. For example, in this number, 1.1582056 exponent of minus 39 is almost zero. How it is represented in each format? In half precision format, it directly represents it say zero. But in single precision format, it has a 23-bit accuracy and it's called as subnormal number in single precision. Then double precision, the subnormal number is changed into the normalized number with negative exponent. Then it is called as negative exponent normalized number. It is same as in part precision. In this field, first box, zero is sine bit, and zero, and the next red color mark zero is integer bit, or sometimes called as implied bit or hidden bit, or sometimes it's called as a leading bit. Here, subnormal is handled in software is in first, it should be converted into the normalized number into, that is, it's converted into higher precision. If it is necessary means, unnecessary means, it should be plus two to zero. Otherwise, the computation is going on. After the computation, it is converted back to the original precision. In hardware, the hardware flags are used to detect the subnormal in our program. Then the flags set the traps to OS compiler and math library. Finally, flags pluses the subnormal into zero. That indicates the gradual underflow in floating point computation. During the execution of subnormal, it exposes the some outcome which is insecure. In these outcomes are execution time, power consumption, memory access pattern, and electromagnetic emission. Along with our actual output, these outcomes are used by the attacker. Then these outcomes are known as side channel. These attacks are called as passive or non-invasive attacks. The execution of a floating point execution time, sorry, exposing of a floating point execution time is powerful attack, and it requires a lot of time for analyzing to retrieve the data. These attacks called as timing side channel or sometimes called as data timing channel attack. So here there are several countermeasures are made for to reduce the side channel attack. First, timing attack is reduced. Timing attacks are caused by variation in execution time. Then the constant execution time is proposed for avoiding the timing attack. In power attack, the actual power consumption is noted by attacker when secure computation is going on. Then the original data is mixed with noise data. Then attacker cannot separate the power traces of noise as well as original data. Then third one is micro architectural attack. It is based on memory patterns stored in buffers. These buffers are generally used in branch prediction, out of order execution, and speculative execution. These entries are flushed frequently. If these entries are not flushed frequently, the attacker launches on the buffers, caches to retrieve the stored information. Finally, is electromagnetic radiation attack. When it is same as the power attack, actual computation is going on the circuit. It emits the electromagnetic radiation. These electromagnetic radiation are also captured by the attacker. If provide a EM circuit means that is a electromagnetic shielding circuit, it prevents the radiation and it adds noise to the EM radiation. Finally, attackers cannot separate the noise as well as the EM radiation blocking to the original computation. These are the several existing work. These existing work are used to frame the problem of our thesis. First one is application of wave propagation simulation on 3D bar. It is degraded by subnormal input. It is simulated in multiprocessor. During the degradation, the performance are going to worst case. So it should be flushed by D normals are zero, DA is it, and flushed to zero, FT is it flux. In second work, software traps are set for flushing the subnormal. And the same time, it provides the separate hardware for denormalizing. Denormalizing is nothing but a process of subnormal in one precision is converted into the higher precision. The drawback is additional hardware is required by floating point unit. In third case, in third work, during the subnormal processing, timing side channel attacks are caused. These timing side channel attacks are caused by the variation in execution time. Then they propose a solution of fixed point constant math library used in the programming. It depends upon language and its compiler. That is the drawback. In another, using the timing side channel, and the attackers launch a deep neural network system to retrieve the image pixel and its weight through the floating point multiplication timing channel. That is FM empty attack. It also consumes the power. It also uses the power attack used to recover the image. The main drawback is it takes a long time for recovering the image. Final one is the same attack is launched using the single instruction, multiple data stream instruction. Here the same solution is proposed. That is called clock precise constant time approach is proposed that eliminates the timing channel in hardware. And its main disadvantage is it is implemented in a single clock source domain. And next one is problem identified. From the existing work, we have identified the several problems. Subnormal increases the first increases the complexity, and same time the negative exponent normal normalized input increases the same complexity of delay. This delay is unintentional. That is, it not predicted how much amount of delay is incurred in each computation. This unintentional delay creates the data timing channel, which exposes the state of the input using its computation time. Computation time is varied, especially in floating point multiplication instruction that holds the different input with the same word length. In 32 bit means, if we give the sum of the input like a subnormal, normalized input, the execution time, that is computation time, is varied. In software implementation of deep neural network and the convolutional neural network for image signal processing is affected easily by data timing channel. Some mitigations are provided in software that depends on compiler, operating system, and processor microarchitecture. And the common method of data timing channel mitigation is constant execution time and avoiding the exceptional input like subnormal. At same time, in output, the subnormal is not allowed. In the research direction, in our research, it consists of four phases. First phase is first designing the subnormal and explore the DTC data timing channel. In second phase, the subnormal processing multiplier is designed with four paths with four different output. After designing in phase three, its data timing channels are explored for how much amount of delay variation is occurred for each output. And finally, the adder and the multiplier are combined in a fused multiply add microarchitecture. It is nothing but a multiply and accumulate unit with the same subnormal processing capabilities are introduced. This is the overall subnormal floating point FMA fused multiply add architecture. It consists of first delay balanced floating point multiplier. At the same time, another floating point adder is there, and it needs a code RAM for storing the instruction, and the data RAM stores the data, that is input, and it provides some multiplexer and a demultiplexer used to select the floating point addition, multiplication, squaring, and finally MAC operations through this network. And three registers or intermediate registers are used to store the intermediate result of MAC multiply and accumulate operation. This is the general overview of our proposed work. And first phase, order is designed with the subnormal processing capability is introduced. It provides the normalized subnormal zero and infinity output in single path. This is the general floating point addition step. First, if you need to add two floating point numbers, its exponent should be equal. And then going to add the mantissa, that is fractional part. If its two exponent are not equal, means first it should be equalized through the alignment step. During the alignment step, compared, that is, the difference between two exponent is used to align the smallest mantissa part of the second input, and then mantissas are added. During the addition, there is two possibilities. One is the carry generation, are another chances of providing the leading zeros. In general, floating point arithmetic does not allow the leading bit, that is more than one bit. It allows a single bit in integer part, and at the same time in mantissa part, it does not allow the leading zeros. In here, there is a chance of carry. The carry is updated to the largest exponent, and it is noted as a final exponent. And at the same time, mantissa is shifted in one bit in right direction. This is the final output of two floating point number. Here, this is the conventional floating point circuit. Here, step 1 to step 5, all steps are mentioned here. First step, swapping multiplexer and the subtractor is used to compare and swap stage. Barrel shifter is used to align the smallest mantissa, and then mantissa adder and subtractors add or subtract the mantissa of the two input. Finally, normalization is taken place with the help of barrel shifter and one bit shifter. Barrel shifter is used to remove the number of leading zeros, and one bit shifter is used to remove the carry bit through the right shifting. Finally, results are rounded. This is the conventional floating point step. Here, there is a chance for adding some exceptional input, just like subnormal input. Here, first combination is two subnormal. The subnormal are denoted as here x1 fields are zero, and at the same time, mantissa field has some non-zero bit. Here, its integer bit is zero. That is, implied bit is implied or hidden bits are zero. Then simply we are going to add the mantissa alone, and at the same time the proposed adder introduce some additional circuit for disabling the implied bit. So then after mantissa addition, there is a chance of getting, if some input does not get the carry, that is integer bit, here it gets the integer bit. Then it's to be updated to the final exponent. Now, two subnormals are giving the normalized input here. In sometimes, two subnormals are giving the same subnormal input. Here, this output denotes the negative exponent. That is called as a negative exponent normalized number. In another case, normalized and subnormal input is given. The same principle is used here. One important point is there. In subnormal input, the implied bit is disabled. In normalized input, we are giving the implied bit. In this process are introduced in our proposed circuit through the some additional gates and multiplexer. First, disable the implied bit for subnormal in alignment step in smallest input, and then if second input also the subnormal means mantissa addition step here, in single precision both inputs are mantissa are 23 bit plus 1 bit implied bit, totally 24 bit. In alignment step, subnormal is disabled in barrel shifter, and at the same time the largest mantissa its implied bit is disabled through this network. Remaining process is same as the conventional floating point addition step. This proposed floating point adder is implemented in Intel Static 3 FPGA. After the synthesis, we get the register level transfer netlist. In this slide, we are going to tell about the delay, area, power difference between the conventional floating point adder, that is normalized floating point adder, and then our proposed adder that handles the normalized and subnormal input. And the delay variation is normalized adder get 65.18 nanosecond, and the normalized subnormal floating point adder gets 17 nanosecond. With slightly varying power consumption. In this step, we analyze that the delay is not reduced in both proposed and conventional order. It affects the throughput also. The throughput is increased in pipelined implementation. Here, subnormal floating point order and conventional floating point order pipelined into 9 stage with the stage delay of 4.41 nanosecond and 6.42 nanosecond with increasing the operating speed of 227 megahertz and 149.85 megahertz. Then pipeline means it increased the slight amount of power. This is the simulation output. The simulation output shows that when the largest two normalized number adds, it overflows and it indicates that it is a infinity result. Then second input shows that both are normalized input gives the normalized output. There is no exception. And at the same time, there is two subnormal numbers are taken for addition. It gives the same subnormal output. Then it indicates the subnormal output. Remaining cases are all produced the normalized result, sometimes produced for two subnormal inputs. Result and discussion of the floating point order. Slightly simple. There is a single path addition that provides the normalized subnormal infinity zero results. Then all input outputs are taken the same amount of time, same amount of execution time. Then there is no chances of data timing channel attack. And the pipeline reduced the longest critical path delay or longest path delay into 6.4 nanosecond for subnormal order with 9 clock cycle latency. And second phase is subnormal processing floating point multiplier. Here, holistic support means it we are taking the entire combination of input, that is subnormal input, negative exponent normalized input, and then normalized input. For the purpose of four path is reduce the normalization and denormalization for NEN and subnormal. In the case that if you are taking the multiple combination of that input, in this normalization and denormalization produce the unintentional delay. How the unintentional delay is produced is shown in next slide, in coming slide. First, one questions are there. Why multiple paths are used in proposed multiplier? But in floating point order, it is a single path. But here, multiplier has a four path or producing the normalized NEN subnormal number. Normalized subnormal zero and infinity output with different execution time. This execution time or computational time is varied unintentionally due to the denormalization and normalization process. Then a single path does not hold the entire output. So we are going to the four path multiplication process in separate exponent and mantissa processing step. Especially the mantissa processing and exponent processing are not common for all input. It's shown in the diagram circuit. Here there is a four path. Path one is a normalized path. It is a status signal. If normalized output is produced, means this is enabled. Remaining are disabled. And second path is subnormal. And the third path is zero. Fourth path is infinity. At the same time, if path one is enabled, means subnormal path one is enabled, means normalized output is produced here. At the same time, here exponent is produced for normalized exponent, normalized number. Mantissa produced for normalized number. Path two is subnormal. Here subnormal exponent is here. Here subnormal mantissa path is here, and zero output. Zero output is produced for two subnormal input denoted in this path here. and zero output is provided in this path 3. Path 4 is infinity path. Infinity path produces here matrices and here produce the exponent. In the here we are analyzing that infinity path and zero path has a less amount of circuit, but normalized path, this is the normalized path for exponent and this is the normalized path for matrices processing. This is the subnormal path for exponent. This is subnormal path for matrices. Here number of circuits are added, then the delay is varied accordingly. How the delay is varied? It's shown in the some possible combination of input. First path produces the normalized path. It is the conventional floating point multiplication. Here directly matrices are multiplied with implied bit is added. Actual single precision input is taken here. Here 23 bit matrix is here and 1 bit implied bit is added during the multiplication step, and at the same time exponent of two inputs are added and then bias is subtracted from that. Next, if any carry is presented, means it is given to the final exponent, that is resultant exponent, and then incremented into 1. This is the conventional floating point multiplication. Here it is exponents are positive. Positive exponents are the called as now it points the largest normalized number, and negative exponents are shows the smallest normalized number called as negative exponent normalized number. Here one important observation is that when two exponents are added, that is any n exponent are added and then it is subtracted, conventional floating point exponent processing is there. Here we have that so that there is a finite exponent, and at the same time here is carry, then it should be added. In another chance, the sum of two, that is SPE is sum of two exponent, the sum of two exponent is less than this bias. The purpose of bias is separate the largest normalized number and the smallest normalized number. The bias is greater than means the path 1 of this case is diverted into the path 3 of case 4. It's shown in next slide. In path 2 is an infinity path. It is there is two largest normalized number. During the multiplication step it goes to overflow and it indicates the infinity. How it is mentioned as infinity? When its exponent field is 8 bit, the two 8 bit exponents are added and bias is subtracted, then we get the 9 bit exponent. This 9 bit exponent is not fitted into the exponent field. Then comes to conclusion of there is in overflow or occurred, then it is omitted in the general multiplication step. And going to path 3, there are analyzing the four case. The four case take the input, first case take the normalized and subnormal input. In second case take the same normalized subnormal input, and third case negative exponent normalized number and subnormal input. In case four, which is diverted from the path 1, here there is a two normalized number with negative exponent, which sum of two exponent is less than the bias. Then only path 1 diverts this input into path 3. Here in case 1, first we can put there is a normalized and subnormal input. When two exponent of the these inputs are added, we get the sum of two exponent, which is greater than bias, and at the same time the matrices are okay. There are different cases. Here it requires the normalization. Normalization is nothing but a removal of leading zeros. And here, this number is normalized in second case. This is produced the subnormal output with leading zeros. And in third case, there is provide some finite exponent, but at the same time, it sum of two exponent is less than the bias, so it cannot be normalized. The output is denormalized. That is, sometime the subnormal number is denoted as a denormal number. That is case 4, which is less than the bias. There is in this state takes more delay than remaining three cases. In part 4, two subnormal inputs are taken for multiplication. The subnormal, these two numbers are very very close to zero. When close to zero numbers are multiplied, the outputs are zero. Then we can test out. That is, it is noted as a gradual underflow condition. Already I told that in previous cases, normalization and denormalization process yields the unintentional delay in software. Oh, okay, man. Discuss pani aadhi. Already I told that the normalization and denormalization take the huge amount of delay for any n subnormal and zero output. Here and in this part 3, four cases needs the additional circuit of leading zero counting and barrel shifter circuit, and fourth cases in additional one set of comparator and subtractor are needed. Then it yields the more delay in denormalization process. Here and the conventional floating point multiplication is the single that is unidirectional barrel shifters. Here we perform the at a time normalization and denormalization. So we have proposed the bidirectional barrel shifter. Here bidirectional barrel shifter replaces the two input mux into three input mux. Here we analyze the delay across the four path in two FPGA implementation. Part one provides the 42.23 nanosecond, and infinity path is 11.62 nanosecond. Normal subnormal path, third path, is 45.50 nanosecond, and subnormal path takes 10.12 nanosecond. And at the same time, the varying delay is measured in Cyclone 3 FPGA. Here subnormal and normal path case, path 3 takes the more delay than remaining three path. This is the RTL net, register transfer netlist after synthesizing the proposed multiplier. This is the output for each normalized number. For normalized number, take the 19.53 nanosecond, and an infinity path takes the 17.54 nanosecond, and and the next input for any n input takes the 21.685 nanosecond. Next is path 3 takes the 23.206 nanosecond. These delays are dynamic analysis of timing, and the previous and the results shown the delay measured in static timing analysis in table. Result discussion here. In conventional software implementation needs the pre-normalization for subnormal input that is converted into higher precision. Here, it's the pre-normalization is not needed. Then a proposed order proves that hardware-based subnormal processing is efficient than software implementation. Here in phase 3, proposed order exploring the delay variation across the four paths that is shown in table 2. In this, delays are causing the data timing channel in hardware implementation. It should be balanced for removing the data timing channel. this delay majorly affects for subnormal inputs. In software implementation, the convolution gives measurable amount of measurable timing difference that opens the data timing channel for attackers. Then attackers launch the attacks and retrieve the convolutional values. In floating point hardware, avoids the subnormal to reduce the DTC. It is a conventional method used that. In here, the data where the DTCs are originated, that should be shown in four parts, and it should be mitigated using three method. And these mitigations are used the control circuit, and the control circuits are two level. That is level one and level two control circuit. The level one control circuit takes the six status signals during the from the external processing circuit, and level two control circuit reduces the seven intermediate signal from level one circuit into two final output signal. This is the level one and level two control circuit. There is a six status signal during the exponent addition, bias subtraction, and comparison between bias and sum of two exponents. These six signals are given in level one input, so level one circuit, and get the output at level two circuit. These two circuit are, this is the eight combinations, entire eight combination of input. Level one circuit produce the seven output. These seven outputs are given to the level two circuits, which gives the two output. The two that is S0 and S1 output indicates that the what type of the output: normalized, negative exponent, infinity, subnormal, and zero. This level two circuit provides the such status signal. There are three mitigation method: multiplexer based method, flip flop based method, and pipeline. In multiplexer based method, the four paths are terminated with the output multiplexer in both exponent and mantissa path, and then our 2-to-4 decoder is connected here, which indicates that what is the corresponding output and its status in each state. That is 0, 1, 2. 0 means normalized, 1 means infinity, 2 means subnormal, 0 means 3 means 0 output. In the next method, four output paths are connected to the individual flip-flops, which are controlled through the same decoder circuit, which the output of 2-to-4 decoder circuit enables disable the flip-flop according to the input given. The corresponding status signals are generated. The status signals are here. These status signals are given to the level one circuit, and then level two. Finally, decoder circuit produces the four output that enables and disables the flip-flop, getting the corresponding output here. Here, the first two method do not reduce the longest path delay, that is critical path delay. Here, the pipeline implementation reduces the critical path delay as well as increase and it increase the throughput. So it is the RTL netlist generated in FPGA implementation. Here it shows the delay. Multiplexer based method provides 48.68 nanosecond longest path delay. Flip flop based method provides 42.56 nanosecond, and pipeline provides the 10.73 nanosecond. Here the first two method speed is reduced because its critical path delay is higher. Here pipeline method and the critical path delay is reduced to 10.73 nanosecond. Its clock speed is increased, and at the same time in pipeline method area is increased due to the pipeline registers are inserted in each stage. This is the balanced output. For example, here it is a normalized output. It takes the 61.776 for multiplexer based method, and infinity output are taken in the same time, and subnormal outputs are taken in 61.776 nanosecond. Here the both method multiplexer method takes the simulation time of 15 nanosecond. The table shows the delay of static timing analysis delay. Here in the simulation shows the dynamic delay, which depends upon the input data. This is the flip-flop based method. Same constant delay is taken for entire output, that is 58.97 nanosecond for entire output. Here in the results discussion of phase 3, yes, the multiplexer and flip-flop method already told that reduce the critical path delay, but pipeline method, pipeline mitigation reduces the critical path delay into 9 clock cycle latency, and at the same time control circuit, multiplexer and flip-flops are increasing the chip area and its associated power consumption. In phase 4 is designing the fused multiply add micro architecture. The micro architecture consists of already in first slide I told that is the overall system architecture. This is the general, that is a complete circuit diagram of FMA micro architecture. After place and run, that is during the synthesis, it gives a RTL netlist, and the design is downloaded into the STATIC3 FPGA after place and route. This process is called chip planner. After this is the add multiply square FMA MAC are not here noted as a micro operation, and the corresponding add operation enabled during this sequence of data called as micro code. Depends upon these 8 micro code are stored in ROM, and its corresponding data are stored in RAM. That is the implementation detail. In the entire circuits are designed using Verilog HDL as well as schematic design. Simulation, RTL simulation is gate level simulation is used. A synthesis tool is Intel Quartus 2. The 6.1 EDA tool is used. Target FPGA is, both FPGAs are used, Static 3 and Cyclone 3. Timing check, static timing analysis is used to check the delay of paths and the adder multiplier as well as FMA. Power estimation is done through the PowerPlay power analyzer tool. These timing analyzer and power analyzer are the inbuilt tool of the Quartus 2 tool. And finally, come to conclusion, the subnormal processing is affected in software, but in hardware circuitry, holistic support of subnormal processing is introduced. Here, the delay variations are create the DTCs in subnormal, sorry, software implementation, but here the entire DTC is removed through the delay balancing method. A simple FPU is floating point unit, that is a FMA unit is designed for simple signal processing applications. This also is again reconfigured for any application, just like a cryptographic application and the convolutional neural network, any other applications of machine learning. The future announcement, this is here the proposed circuits are implemented in FPGA design. In future announcement, these circuits are implemented in application-specific integrated circuit. During the ASIC design, the static timing analysis should be accurate. It should be chances of inserting in the hardware trojan as well as the launch of the timing channel attacks. So we need, we will perform the static timing analysis for the same FMA micro architecture in future. This is the reference.
Thank you. Vendor. Discuss your courses. What are the courses you did? And the publication.
This is.
The sir shows the journal publications. So one of the phase of work is published in Annexure 1 SEA journal under the title of the first one. It is the World Science Publisher. Sir, thank you for listening. And Sindhil sir, thank you for your presentation. Sir, any queries we want to discuss? Pandian sir and Saranan sir.
Madam, I'll start with the questions.
Hello, sir. Mike,
shall I
unmute
start with the
panel.
questions?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. See, here we are trying to reduce the delay, reduce the area, power consumption level. So these are some of the objectives what is defined.
Yes, sir.
Now,
yes.
Delay in the sense, what is the targeted delay? For example, what is that intended application and why you are trying to reduce the delay to that particular targeted values?
Yes, sir. The subnormal processing, especially subnormal processing, any and negative exponent normalized input takes the huge amount of delay in software implementation. It is unpredictable because of normalization and denormalization, especially in multiplication. And addition, the delay is not concerned because here single part combines the entire output. So
okay.
The delay is not a problem, sir. But in multiplier, subnormal processing in software implementation, in a previous proposal shows that even 100 clock cycle or 300 clock cycle for subnormal processing, it's an unpredicted delay.
Hello, sir. Sorry to disturb you, sir. Actually, he did only what are the things he did means first one is the conventional in conventional method,
okay.
The multiplier, adder and all. They did only, they are considering only the positive exponent and the normalized number. They are not considering the negative exponent and negative normalized numbers. This and all not considered in the conventional method, actually what the processor is did. So he tried in the software while considering all the cases of normal normal numbers and subnormal numbers and then negative exponent, both are normalized, all the cases. But while doing the software, it the programming itself, it takes more time. So the time is, therefore we are considering one factor as a time delay. Delay is the major issue for implementing in software. This will be whether it is reduced for hardware implementation or not, because everything it's in a hardware. That's why he implemented that concept in the hardware FPGA implementation.
Okay. That's all, sir. Now this power consumption levels, power consumption levels, what is the targeted values of power consumption? Because you will have to do the fabrication on the die or something like that and then go for the packaging. Then only we'll come to know based on your packaging and how much of your distribution happens.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So what was the targeted, any specific target you had? Because these are computational incentive very intensive. Power consumption will be very high. Did you think about any values, specific values?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
We will incorporate that in our synapses, sir. Itself.
Okay, madam. Next,
so
is,
it is in a targeted value. Targeted we have value. To include it in that. Okay,
correct,
sir.
Madam. Because that is mentioned in the objectives, you should have some values.
Yes.
To that.
Yes, sir.
Then in slide 9, no, if you are seeing the slide 9, you are talking about the security. One specific point I wanted to bring out is this EM radiation attack you are talking about.
Yes, sir.
Are you talking about EMP hardening or something like that?
No, sir. Just I am focusing only on the timing side channel, sir. Because timing
not
side
nothing
side...
any nothing specific to that. Because
yes,
if you
sir.
Start projecting those lines, then whether the EMIMC tests have been carried out, what is the standards you have followed, those things will start coming in. Okay.
So we are not concentrating on the security part, sir. But the introduction itself is easy. But it is not included in the synapses
correct.
And
I'm just questioning.
Okay. Sir. You, that is welcome, sir.
Yes, sir. What are the specific tools you had used for carrying out the simulation?
Yes, sir. Intel Quartus 2, sir. FPGA implementation, sir.
Okay, for the simulation purposes, okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, for example, if I wanted to do the fabrication of this, then you will have to do the routing and then you have to carry
out some
of the studies and then only give it for fabrication.
Yes, sir.
Will be required? The same tools will be used or you have a different tools for that?
That is your, sir, mentioned as a sir, integrated circuit design, sir. Using Cadence or Synapses tool,
sir, already he implemented in the Cadence.
Okay, and that can be going as a CAM file only directly to the vendor. He can fabricate. Is it possible?
Fabrication
is possible.
Fabrication
is possible. Yeah. Sorry, before the fabrication, it requires several step of working, sir. The timing analysis should be carried out. And if in Python implementation, we are providing the clock. Because the clock is a major issue and it takes a major work in back-end implementation of ASIC design, sir. Whether it is a clock, multiple clock are provided, it takes one by one, sir. And then clock is affects the timing also, sir.
Here in okay, now, is, no, no. Sir? No, one specific point I want to ask you. Do you know what the manufacturer or the fabricators will ask for inputs from you? Because when you carry out the simulation,
yes, sir.
Post simulation, when you wanted to give anything for any fab, you know what methods of inputs they ask from you to carry out the fabrication. Are you having any idea?
Yes, sir, I am get the idea.
See, those things and all also you should consider, because just doing only simulation studies, no, it is very easy, because subsequently when you want to fabricate, no. It is simulation will be completed in 6 months or 1 year. But what will happen when you really want to give it to the manufacturer, the way he is going to ask you a lot of inputs will be totally different. And you will not be able to even, and all the simulation will go back to square zero only. And then start from beginning. That is why I am trying to say that you should consider those inputs also. The practical aspects also we should
Sir, one suggestion, sir. In physical design, in the fabrication process, first it is affected by the timing behavior. In simulation, we are just take the APG implementation. Its timing is entirely different from the physical design, sir. Here, we are taking the single step of timing analysis. But in back-end design, in the fabrication process, each time the timing is checked one by one. If circuit is correct, sir, but wire and gate delay is varied, then output is totally collapsed. We get the wrong output. Our output during the simulation, we get the correct output, sir. But in integrated circuit physical design, we get the wrong output due to the timing variations across the wire net and gate delay, sir. So timing analysis must be, you are correct telling the take a lot of amount of time, sir.
Okay. Now one more question I wanted to ask you. This simulation what you carried out, did you implement on the FPGA?
Yes, sir.
So what FPGA you had used?
Static 3 and Cyclone 3 FPGA, sir.
Okay, so there you are comfortable with the performance and this thing, no? Or the
Comfortable, sir. Because the FPGA timing analysis for this static 3 FPGA and our next step is the Cyclone 3. The two FPGAs are taking different amount of time. So each static timing analysis method we performed correctly, sir.
Okay.
Circuit now, is example, not affected, sir. The circuit is not affected while simulating both the softwares, sir. But we didn't check for any parameters while go for fabrications. This is not included in the thesis also,
this
sir.
Is okay.
It is our extension work only. We are mentioned it. Future work.
Okay. Then one more point. See, there are a lot of MAC operations available on the commercially available DSP processor.
Yes, sir.
They have some specific performance because the latest processor and all, if you see, they have some specific processing capability. They have they also have some methods of doing the MAC operations. Okay. So, did you compare any performance with that?
No, sir. Still, the subnormal processing is omitted for floating point operations, sir, in MAC operation. Any signal processing application, conventional
Once again, sir, sorry. Actually, the MAC operations in the existing work, they are not considered the subnormal, sir. So, therefore, we are concentrating on that. And therefore, it is not in the position to compare the existing work. Because in the existing work, they indicated as it is an exceptional cases. So, the output is zero. They are omitting the initial stages itself. They are not considering all the circuit. So, for this purpose only, we have a problem of the side channel effect, the theft and all it is happening. So, we are concentrating more on that. How we will include this category of our input, how it will be evaluated. Mm. That is our main aim, sir. Therefore, in existing work, nowhere it is presented. So we are not able to compare with that. But this one is clearly mentioned in the conclusion, sir. In synopsis, in the conclusion itself, it is clearly mentioned. Because no one has implemented, they are not taken into account for negative exponent. So that is the word we are taken. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, madam. Okay, I have done from my side, madam.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, any queries from the Saravanan, sir?
Sindel. What? In the literature review, anybody working in the using this Kaden software?
No, sir. No, sir. In literature, only software implementation, sir. All of the implementation, these five works are used to frame the problem formulation. These are, except fourth one, just implement the microcontroller, because the microcontroller runs the DNN application in the form of software, sir. Looking the five literature reviews are based on software, sir. No one coming to the hardware. But in second literature, it provides denormalizing hardware. It used to handle, that is, detect the subnormal, and then it converts the higher precision. It is in before the arithmetic, that is, addition or subtraction and the multiplication process, sir. After it, the original come to the original. So in second work, you using the denormalizing hardware. Due to the huge amount of delay and the power, so it is not, it was preferred in any other present work, sir.
The thing will be, if somebody worked with the same Kaden software, we may compare our results.
No, sir, no, sir. Still, anybody work on, anybody?
With our knowledge, no one has implemented in this cases, but the other cases they are included. Anyway, we will include it, sir, because the processor and all available, the Kaden and hardware. So based on that, we can include it, sir. It may be possible, I think so, because in 2019 also they are implemented, but they are not concentrating on these two cases, that's all. That we can mention it and compare our work also, sir. Then only it is good. I think so. Your suggestion is right, sir. We think of it and we included in our synopsis itself, sir. Or otherwise, we will include it in thesis.
Okay, ma'am. That's all from my side.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Now we want to discuss about the title, sir, because I'm not satisfied with the title, because in DC meeting, confirmation meeting, we give the title as...
Sindel, go to the title.
SOC, hybrid wave pipeline SOC interconnect using in biomedical signal processing. But this is, now it is changed, sir. Entirely it is changed. He did only the arithmetic operations of floating point. So the title, we want to check, sir. Sir, whether I share the title, now I make it four different titles, sir. Just to go through it and give the suggestion for that, sir. Pradeep, sir, share pannunga. Sir, once again, sorry. Stop sharing, yes. This one. Hello, sir. Now the screen is shared. It is visible, sir.
Not that, ma'am. Not
it is. It is not visible, na.
It shows your background.
Oh. Share agla. Code problem, brother. Okay, sir. Some problem is there. I am not able to share it because I give the option to Sendil. Therefore, I'm not having an option. Sir, whether I read the title, sir?
Yes, yes.
Whether I can read the title?
Yes,
ma'am. Okay. Sir, first one is design and implementation of subnormal floating point SOC for secured signal processing using pipeline interconnect. This is why I included the secured signal processing means in DC meeting we confirmed the title as signal processing. Therefore, I included it. But it is not in the part of our thesis work now. The work is now it's different. So, therefore, one more title I make it. That is design and implementation of subnormal floating point arithmetic SOC for timing side channel effect. This is one more suggestion, sir. And another thing is design and implementation of subnormal floating point arithmetic SOC for secured signal processing. Design and implementation of subnormal floating point arithmetic because he did only subnormal. We are concentrating only on the subnormal floating point arithmetic operation, all adders, multipliers, everything in chip on integration. So it is for secured signal processing. That is okay. These are the three topics I made it, sir. Which one is suitable and how we can change
the second somewhat related closely.
Second one, sir. Sir Pandian, sir.
Yes, madam.
Which one is suitable for us, sir?
Madam, see, for me, no, that day, I think one day you had sent by mail.
Yes, sir.
I suggested. Which was that? Is it same as what Sarah is mentioning now?
Yes, sir. That
we
is
can go ahead with that. There is no problem.
That second one only, sir, is mentioning.
Correct. I think I remember that only.
Yes,
the same
sir.
Thing will go,
yes.
Madam. It is rightly
okay. Hmm? Okay. Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yes,
any other suggestions, sir?
That examiners also you had shown me.
Examiners list. Okay.
That also I am fine with it. What about sir? Sir has also seen that?
I have seen it. I have received it through mail. And I have gone through that, you will proceed with that.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Then same status, that's all. The examiner list is, I won't change, sir. The title also, the second title I considered for the synopsis, sir. It is possible means we can include the comparison table in the synopsis, sir. Or otherwise, we assured that we included it in thesis.
Okay.
And one more suggestion the Pandians are given is fabrication limitations, the delay. So what is our target limit? And that also we find out and we included in the thesis, sir.
Okay, madam. Okay.
Hello, Pandian sir.
These are
the suggestions you were given, sir. That we included in the synopsis meeting report. And I send it to you, sir. Both of them. I send it today itself. If any suggestion is there, after modifications, I will upload it, sir. Within
fine,
one
madam,
hour,
fine.
I send it the discussion point for your mail, sir. For you or WhatsApp. After getting the approval only, I uploaded it in the Anna University website. Okay, sir. Thank you for your valuable suggestions and spending the time for us. Thank you, sir. Pandian, sir, and as well as the Saravanan, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Now I end the recording process, sir. Shall I end with the recording status?
Yes. Bye.